So as I was telling you, as I was just trying to tell you all people that understanding Selenium or writing code in Selenium will mostly depend upon being able to read the documentation, and the rest of it will be your programming skills, that is Go Java programming. Okay, so let me quickly take you through this example in front of you. So we all understand what is a package. I have created a package where I have given it any name. I have a web driver. Okay. Now we are making use of 3x Selenium web driver. 3x is the 3x version, wherein what happens, you have to explicitly set the system property that you are saying you are going to make use of this driver. I'll talk more of this later on. Don't worry about this line. What I did is, now let's say I my first Selenium, just 1 minute. Okay, so let's say I want to write a program from scratch, and let's see what we can do about it. So let's say I somehow don't know a lot about Selenium, but I know how to do it my documentation, and I'm good at Java programming. So I will create a class, my first. Okay, so what we can do, I know that there has to be a driver, right? So in the main, what I'm going to do is main, and driver is a web driver, right? Because what is a driver? First of all, driver is a piece of, what is a driver? In an English terminology, driver is one who drives. So here you are creating a web driver who drives the communication with the browser. So I know web driver is there. I type web driver, I say control space bar. So it gives me an option to choose which driver I want, right? So I double click here. So it got imported automatically. This is a feature of Eclipse, right? So I'll call driver equal to, so if you guys and girls remember that car C equal to either BMW or Maruti. And this is where I'm using overriding. Why? Because given an input by user, here I'm hard coding, but in future given an input from the end user, that driver instance will get created and the corresponding method will get called. Yes, no? So I'll say new because I want to create an instance, and then I'll say, what I will say, web driver, right? But Firefox, I'll say fire and I'll hit enter. So I have created my web driver. Now for the time being, I will copy this statement, and what is the purpose of this, we'll talk about it later. But for now, let me copy and paste this here. Okay, here I'm setting a system property where I'm stating that I want to make use of a Geico driver, which is a Firefox driver. I'm done with this. Now I want to know how to use it. So I go to the documentation, web driver. So let me open the documentation here. Selenium, here I will go. And then I will go to web driver. Okay, so I still do not know how to program Selenium. I'll start playing around up and down here. Okay, so find element is that this. So I see get, and I remember having seen get earlier. So I see that it says load a new web page in the current browser, right? Isn't it? So I know that it will open a current any URL for me. So I'll say driver dot driver dot get of a string. So let's say I want to load this particular page for myself. Let's say google.com. I do Google. It brings up this page. I'll copy this whole URL and I'm going to put it here, right? Are we good so far? So let's at least see whether it actually does what I'm trying to do. Before I write more code, I just want to verify that am I in the right direction. I'll right click, run as Java application. So let's wait and watch what is happening. Okay. okay, so browser is launched and it opened the Google for me. That was as simple as that, right? Now let me continue further. It's still running, so I'll close this. Now I'll go back again in my documentation, and I will see what else I can do here. So there is a get current URL, get page source, get title, lot of things are there. Okay, so first of all, let's say get title. So what it gives the title of the current page. So if I go back here and try to open Google for myself, what is the title? Is this is Google, right? Yes, at the top. So let me get the title. So I'll say driver.get title, right? And if you will see, it returns colon string. It returns a string, right? Please don't type. I'll give time to all of you. Please just follow the instructions now. Okay. So I did this. Now, how do I know it returns title? If I go to that and if I press F2 on that, it says it returns a string, isn't it? If it returns a string, then I can store it in. It's a coffee machine which is returning coffee. So I'll say string title equal to this. And then let's say sysout. Sysout of. Okay, now tell me where is selenium in this. Anybody saw any selenium? There is no selenium, right? It's all Java, and it's all Java. And as you will move ahead, you will see that just by knowing how to program Java, how to program loops, how to program iterator, how to understand inheritance, how to understand other topics in Java, this is what you need to do basically. So let's try to run this now. Right click, run as Java application. So it opened the browser for me, and we are done here. Like me, so did you see the Google there? It is as simple as that. Okay, so now what I want you people to do is create a program, use this method which I have given here, and use two another method from the documentation. And wait, two method is, one is you will get the page source, okay, and you will make use of get, and then get current URL and get page source and get title. This four should be enough. Okay, so let's get started. So if you will see, I have this page in front of you. These are few of the methods. Maybe you can use get title, get page source, get current URL. Okay, so for now this should be sufficient. Okay, please pay attention here. So now WebDriver is very much similar, or it does everything very much similar to what we do as an end user of a browser. So if I go to google.com, for example, so this is what I am opening, right? If I go here, here I can say navigate.refresh this page. But if I say back or forward, it will not go back or forward. Why? Because to go to back, I should have clicked maybe Gmail images. After I clicked here, then I have an option of back, right? Enabled. Isn't it? So after clicking there, you can say navigate back or forward or whatever it is. Okay, so the APIs wouldn't do anything different from what you generally do. So what you can do, or we will see in some time, that after you say navigate, you can only refresh at that page and not anything else, because you cannot move back and forward. Yes, is there any doubt here? Anybody, is it clear to you so far?
Sir,
just 1 minute. pause my recording. So we have come this far that we know how to read documentation, some basic things we can do. Okay, now what we have to do is I'm going to share one file code with you, and we will automate all the components there. So the file is here. Okay, so this is a regular HTML file. I'm mailing it to all of you on the group. So today itself we'll document each of this component, that how we access a text box, how we this, how we click here, how we click on hyperlink, how we select a values in the drop down. That's what Selenium Web Automation is about, isn't it? Okay, and you will notice that if you know how to do it for one element, you can do it consistently for all the elements. It is as simple as that. Yes, so I'm mailing this source code to you. This is an HTML file. Copy it, put it in any directory, and then we will go ahead. Okay, now let's get started a little further. So if I were to move ahead with what we have already done so far, I have a file here locating multiple elements. Okay, so let's go through it one by one. So I will call it locating multiple elements. I'll make a file 2 here. So all this code is available on Bitbucket. Please make use of it. Okay, so if I go here, and I'm assuming we understand what is all this, so I'll delete this for now, right? We understand my first Selenium program, so this much we did, right? And we are pretty confident with what we have done so far, no doubt here, isn't it? Now what I want to do is I want to access the components on this particular page. So there are two things which we need to install. Now if you will go and look at the source code of this file, this one, if you go to google.com here, and if you right click and view page source, view page source, you will see something like this. This doesn't look really pretty good thing to read, right? If you had to read this, you would be discouraged to actually learn documentation if I tell you please understand this, right? So in that case, what we will do is I'll go to my Firefox again, Firefox browser, and I'll search for okay, so what I will do is I will search for Firebug and Firepath. How will I do that? I will go to Firebug, firebug, enter. Okay, the first link which comes up here, I'll click on that. In my case, it is already installed, so you will choose you will choose add to Firefox, right? After that, Firepath. So Firebug and Firepath. So please note, please look at this display here. I'll give you time to do it later, please, all of you. Okay, after that I went to Firepath. I again search for it, and the first link which I get is the one which I need to install. I'll click on this, and again I'll have an option to add to Firefox. Okay, once I'm done with it, next, now if I want to look at the element, so here what I want to do is on this page called Google, here I want to enter some data on this text box. So one way was to right click and view source and find out how and where that element is. If you have Firebug installed on your machine, what do? You right click on that element. Everybody following?
Yes.
And you will simply say inspect with Firebug. and then you will see this icon here next to the bug. This icon, I'll click that and hover my mouse on that. So it will highlight me that particular component I want to use. Okay, so two things. I'm mailing you a file. Take that, put it in the some directory in your project. Second, install Firebug and Firepath, and then from there we'll go forward. Okay, so let me mail the file to you. And one more thing, please, all of you, please remember, I'm going to send you some links today. Make sure you download all those links today itself on your personal laptops at home. So the entire code on Bitbucket, I will give you a link and I will tell you how to download. Make sure it is downloaded today itself. Plus few other things with respect to documentation and all that. I will send you a link today. Before you come to class tomorrow, please, just 1 minute, I'll come to you. Kushal, I have sent you a link. Can you please open that link? I have sent you on WhatsApp. Please open that and send me a request to join the group. Okay everybody, please, I am sending you a file here. If you will see HTML components, please here pay your attention. So just go to this particular thread, control A, and copy this whole code and go to your project, right click, say new, and search for an HTML file. Go to other HTML and choose this HTML and whatever name you want to give, finish it. And then control A and paste that whole code. Is it clear? So I have just sent it to you. Please take that. Take it from the Google group. Once again, please pay attention. What you have to do is, after you have created the file in Eclipse, so let's say this is the file I created. Okay. I try to give it some name which, if you want to use later, you will know. So maybe multiple elements or whatever. I'll right click, go to properties. I will open, copy this path, and I'll put it in browser here. Once I put it in browser, then the URL which I have to open is this URL. Like I said, driver.get of the URL, right? So this is the URL you have to put there. Is it clear to everybody? Yes, so please do this, and then after that we'll continue with the other components. Now let's start to work on Selenium. So what we have to do as a part of Selenium is that on this page here in front of you, you have to find an element which is this element, right, and do something with it. So for the time being, what I'm going to do is, in my source code, I'll remove this red color So you can do it later or whenever you want to. That is not very important, but for example, my locating multiple elements. So this is a source code. I will go and remove the class here. Okay, don't worry much about that. Even if it is there, it's okay. Was a new file, right? So I'm not programming on this. This and this file is same for me. I'll delete this. Okay, so this is the browser. I will open that browser in, oh sorry, this is the HTML which I'm opening in the browser in front of all of you. Okay, so we are going to program on this. Now as a part of programming, what I have to do is I have to be able to access that element and do whatever I need to do, right? So if you have successfully installed your Firebug, you can right click, inspect with Firebug. So please do that, all of you. Yes, no, you have to restart browser if you have installed it. It requires browser restart. Yes, so if you will see here, if you hover on this input, it highlights that particular component, isn't it? So it means it is an input button or input tag. ID of that tag is fname, type is text. Okay, so let me just copy this. So you guys should understand one thing, that in HTML there is an input tag. Yes?
Yes,
input tag has an attribute ID with a value of fname, another attribute type with a value of text, another attribute with a value equal to this, and name is first name. Okay,
yes.
Any doubt here?
No.
Okay, you are also clear? I'm
yes.
Sorry, I forgot your name.
Abhilash.
Okay, yeah, clear so far?
Yes,
yes. Now what I have to do is driver, so I'm going to inspect this particular element, and it has ID and name. Now there are various methods, approaches available where we can find the elements on a page. So the methods which we are going to look at as part of this Selenium course is, how do we find by class name, by CSS selector, by ID, by link name, by partial text, by tag name, by XPath. So there are a lot of bys, but for now we are going to focus on name and ID today. So what I am going to do is, I am going to go back to my original program, the first one which I created, and I am going to delete this, and I am going to put this instead of this URL here. What I'm going to do, I'll go to the browser and take this whole URL here and put it back. Please don't try it now, I'll give you time to do it all. So I'll put it here, and let me see while launching this program if I'm able to get that particular URL. The reason is that let's not add so many things that it becomes difficult to debug, right? Right click, run as Java application. So yes, it did launch for me, right? So let's close it for the time being. Now is where our finding starts. Now again, where should I start looking for? How do I know? How should I code? Yes. Okay, so I'll go back to documentation. And since I have already bookmarked that page, I will go here. So so I'm looking at Firefox, right? So I will go to the package for that one. Firefox driver, right? So let me just start navigating this. I see a lot of find element here, right? or so if you will see, fine, okay, all this is. Now let me once again go to org open QA Selenium. Okay, here I had web driver, right? I went to web driver link and I have some constructor, and then I see a lot of methods here, find element, find, lot of them are there, right? Okay, so it must be doing what? It must be finding some element for me. So I will say driver driver dot find element, right? Don't worry about second verse, first we'll take element. Okay, inside that there is a buy, so let me click on the buy here. Okay, so what options are there? Buy class, buy CSS, buy ID, buy, so many buys. So I have buy, let's say buy dot name is there. Yes, and in that I'll pass what? Name of the field. So where is that for me? I'll go to the browser. I was inspecting it here. Let's say, which was that one? Maybe this one, yeah. So I'll inspect it, and then I'll say what is the name is F name. I'll copy this, and then yes. Now what does this method return? Find element returns, either I can press F2 here, it returns a web element. Web element means an element of a web, and in this case it is which element? First name element, right? Who did not understand this? Everybody clear? Abhilasha? So I will copy, either I can copy this from here, or I'll go back to my documentation. Where is my documentation? Okay, it was here, right? So I'll go back once again. This method I was using, find element, right? It returns what? Web element. I can copy this and I can put it here, right? Web element WE1. Are we done?
Yes.
Now by doing this I have created a reference which is pointing to first name, right? So if I have reference pointing to that particular object or component, I can do operations on that with the help of WE1. Okay, now let me go back to the documentation and let me open this. Okay, so we can read the documentation of that. So you will see that web element is an object, yes, or some class. That class has so many methods. So it has a method called clear, it has a method called click, it has find element also, lot of things are there. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, there is one called send keys. What does it do? Use this method to simulate typing into an element which may set its value. So typing means it is like, if I use this method, it is as good as simulating typing. Yes, so I will copy this. Okay, I'll copy this method, or I can simply say WE1 dot send keys and I'll say hello. Yes? So let me close this for now. This is the one I have closed. Right click, run as Java application. Let's see what is happening. Do you see hello coming? Yeah, so is it clear?
Yes.
So can you all now please do this program, and you can refer to the program in front of you, but I encourage you to one more minute here, please, before you turn to your machines. All of you, you also please. Now, if you will see that this particular page, which has documentation for web element, you can say clear, you can say click, you can say this, you can say a lot of things you can do. What it means is web element is a web element. It could be a link or a button or a text box or any kind of a web element. If it is clickable, then click will work. I can say click here, or let's say I can say submit. Submit, we can do a submit of button, right? But if I submit a text box, will anything happen? Similarly, here also, if you type submit deliberately, nothing is going to happen. You understanding what I am trying to say? All the web elements is a web element only. Different web element based upon its functionality it is offering, you could submit it or you could type something or whatever. So if you do an operation which is not supported by it, nothing will happen. But if it is supported, that action will take place. So like I said, send keys. Can I send keys to a button? I cannot. But I can do it for a text box. Okay? So keeping that in mind, now what you have to do, one more minute before you jump. So you have to send in data in this, send in data in this. You have to click this button here. You have to click this. Okay? Now, after that, you have to try also for radio button. Okay, so let's see how much we can do. And one second. Now the intention is I could show you code how to do it. That is not how we are going to do it. I want you people to struggle and figure out what you can do, what you should do. For example, in the case of radio button, it's a little difficult than the first one. Okay, try it is a simple button which is you select it and click it, that will work. But there is a link here, right? Hyperlink, do you see? Click me. So like there was a driver.findElementby link name option is also there. So if you will see by link text, so you say driver.findElementby link text, in that double quotes you will hear instead of registration what should go there, click. Is it clear? Okay, so you have next 15 minutes to try out all of this. Okay, so please pay here some attention. Your assignment is, there are a few assignments. Whatever you can do, do as much as possible. So one is login into Facebook, login into Gmail. These are two assignments. Then your third assignment is go to Yahoo registration page. And in the Yahoo registration page, you will see a lot of components there like this. So if you go to Yahoo registration, I want all of you to try filling in all these details properly and then click on continue. First is a valid use case, means all the fields are valid fields, and then how we do error handling will come to it later. Okay, so if you will go here, if you will go to courses, now you can jump to Selenium assignments. So you have, with the things we have covered so far, you have good number of assignments you can do. So okay, so I think you all can address all these fields now, right? So in the drop down, select the country and all these things. So you have three things: Facebook login, Gmail login, and Yahoo page registration. So you can do, not all three is not required, just at least try one or two and make sure that you can at least make use of documentation and understand what needs to be done or what it is, right? Okay, this page is taking time to load, but I hope it is unclear, right? So we have made a good progress with respect to playing around with what you say, find elements. We have covered few. Now, in case a lot of people had been asking this question, what if there are two elements, right, with the same name? Then you get, there is a method called find elements. It returns you a list of those elements as a web element. Okay, so the bottom line is you always get a web element, and on the web element you have so many operations which you can perform. Yes, any question? Okay, so we will next, when we meet tomorrow, we will look at partial. So this I want you people to try. I will not tell you how to work on this. By tag name also, these two you have to try yourself. If you have questions, please come back and ask me. Partial link text and tag name. Okay. Okay, now next, what you people will do is, if you are already done with what we were looking at, please fetch, suppose that second text box which was having a value mouse here. I want you to fetch this value and display it for me. This value of the mouse, please display it for me. Is the question clear?